In this segment, we're going to talk about is A times B same as B times A, which is basically we're trying to see that whether the commutative law of multiplication of matrices is that valid. So the first thing which you have to understand is that if A times B is possible, if A times B is possible, then the number of columns of A has to be same as the number of rows of B. So let's suppose this is M by N and this is N by P. Yes, A times B is possible. Then if I try to say, hey, B times A, this is N rows and P columns, and this is M rows and N columns, I already see that the number of columns here is not same as the number of rows here, unless and until P is same as M. So if P is same as M, then I have to know that, hey, then the size of the matrix B has to be square, and A also has to be square, and they have to be the same dimension. Only then is there a possibility that A times B will be same as B times A. So you can very well see that if A times B is allowed, B times A cannot be allowed, and it can be only allowed now if this is same as this. And if we consider this to be same as this, then we have to also assume that it has to be a square matrix. Both of these have to be square matrices in order for that to be possible. Even then, if you have two square matrices, so if I have two square matrices, let's suppose, of the same size, n by n, and I say, hey, is this true? No, this is not generally true. Even if you have two matrices of which are square and of the same size, even then you will find out that the commutative law of multiplication is not valid. Let's take an example. If we have A given as 6, 3, 2, 5, and B given as minus 3, 2, 1, 5. So we got these two matrices here, and then if we find A times B is allowed because the number of columns here is the same as the number of rows here. But if we do the matrix multiplication by what we have learned in matrix multiplication, we get minus 15, 27, minus 1, 29. And then if we want to calculate B times A, do we get the same matrix? I don't know. So let's see if what we get for B times A. B times A turns out to be minus 14, 1, 16, and 28. And that's not the same matrix. So in this case, A times B is not equal to B times A. So in most cases, you will find out that commutative law of multiplication is not possible for multiplication. Commutative law is not valid for multiplication. So there are two things which are going on. First, you have to match the orders and in such a fashion that A and B are both of the same size and they're both square. And that's only a necessary condition. But the sufficient condition then is to multiply two matrices and see whether they are the same element by element, which we don't find to be the case in here. But there are cases where A times will be equal to B times A. That'll be more clear when we see some special cases where, let's suppose this matrix is the inverse of that matrix, or this matrix is the inverse of that matrix, then that will be true. But that's down the road, we won't look at that. But this is the end of this segment.